स्टैंडर्ड 10th सब्जेक्ट साइंस एंड टेक्नोलॉजी पार्ट फर्स्ट. दिस इज द ब्रिज कोर्स ऑफ 1st to 4th July. स्टूडेंट, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट द 10th स्टैंडर्ड साइंस ब्रिज कोर्स. We today discussed about only activity sheet number 1 and 2 of part 1. We already studied about the study of the sound. Okay, so what are the sound waves? You know about that. Energy is create the sensation of hearing in our ears, and this energy in the form of waves. You know about that. Then what is longitudinal waves? You also know about that. The particles of the medium oscillate about their center of mean position in the direction parallel to the propagation of the wave. Such waves are called as longitudinal waves. Then see, the waves created by dropping a stone in the still water. Here, what happens? See, the particles of the water oscillate up and down. So these oscillations are perpendicular to the direction of propagation of the waves. Such waves are called as transverse waves. म्हणजे longitudinal waves आणि transverse waves कशा असतात हे तुमच्या लक्षात आलेलं आहे. Then see, sound waves मध्ये आता इथं बघितलं आपण तर इथे काय होतात. So we find here the alternate bands of compression and रेरफ्रॅक्शन. तर आपल्याला इथं काय दिसतात, कॉम्प्रेन्शन्स अँड रेरफ्रॅक्शन. कॉम्प्रेन्शन्स अँड रेरफ्रॅक्शन्स, दीज आर द अल्टरनेट बँड्स. सो हियर सी, सी हियर दिस फिगर 12.1 शोज द चेंजेस इन द डेन्सिटी इन ए. हियर B shows the changes in pressure. The changes in the density or pressure that shown in the form of graph here in the figure C. So here forms waves. So that are the sound waves. Here crest and trough is formed. So these waves are in the form of crest and troughs. Okay. So the wavelength of the sound wave, that is indicated by lambda, and its frequency, it is indicated by nu. Amplitude, what is amplitude? It is the maximum value of pressure or density, and that is indicated by A. Then see the time, so that is denoted by capital T. So it is a time that is taken for one oscillation of the pressure or density. आता एक oscillation म्हणजे काय, one complete wave, that is called as a one oscillation. Okay, the value of frequency determines by the pitch, or that means that is higher or lower pitch of the sound, while the value of amplitude determines the strength of the loudness. Loudness किती आहे त्याची strength determine केला जातो. So we already discussed all these things in previous standard. Here next point is see, sound waves. So the distance covered by the point on the wave in a unit time, that is called as the velocity of the sound wave, and it is determined by the formula velocity is equal to distance upon time. And here see, any point on the sound wave that covers the distance equals to the lambda, that is the wavelength in the time t. Thus velocity of the sound is, velocity is equal to wavelength upon the time period. So that equals to V is equal to lambda upon time. Here lambda means 1 upon time. So that is a mu. Therefore V is equal to mu into lambda. So thus velocity of a sound is equal to wavelength into frequency. So here we also discussed about this audible, infra and ultrasound in previous standard. The limits of hearing of the human ear are 20 hertz to 20,000 hertz. Here see, our ears cannot hear the sound of frequency lower than 20 hertz and higher than 20,000 hertz. That is, 20,000 hertz means 20 kilohertz. Here, sound with the frequency smaller than 20 hertz is called as the infrasound. Sound with frequency smaller than 20 hertz, that is the infrasound. Then see, sound waves with the frequency greater than 20 kilohertz are called as ultrasound. The sound with the frequency greater than 20 hertz, and that is called as the ultrasound. So here some examples are dog, mouse, bat, dolphin that have special ability to hear ultrasonic sounds, and the children under 5 year age and some creatures or insects can also hear these waves with the frequency up to 25 kilohertz. And bats, mice, dolphins, they can also produce the ultrasound. Then see here, reverberation. What is reverberation? See here, sound waves get reflected from walls and roofs of the room multiple times. This causes a single sound to heard not once but continuously. एकच सिंगल साउंड जो आहे तर तो काय होतो, एकदाच काय होतो, ऐकू येत नाही, तर तो काय होतो, अनेक वेळाला ऐकू येतो कंटिन्युअसली. सो दॅट इज कॉल्ड ॲज रिव्हर्बरेशन. टू रिमूव धिस रिव्हर्बरेशन, सो डिफरंट ऑडिटोरियम्स हॅव स्पेशल टाईप ऑफ अरेंजमेंट्स ऑफ द सीट्स. सो दॅट इज गिवन इन धिस डायग्रॅम. सी हियर. देन सी नेक्स्ट पॉईंट इज सोनार. इट इज अ शॉर्ट फॉर्म ऑफ साऊंड नेव्हिगेशन अँड रेंजिंग. It is used to determine the direction, distance and speed of an underwater object with the help of ultrasonic sound waves. So this sonar system that have transmitters, receivers which are fitted on the ships or on the boats, and thus they can determine the direction or the distance of the ship from the bottom of the sea. So here see, sonar is used to determine the depth of the sea, and it is also used to search underwater hills, valleys, submarines, icebergs, sunken ships, etc. So here see, this is the structure of human ear. So human ear, that is divided into outer, middle and outer, middle and inner ears. So there are different parts. Here outer pinna is here. Then middle part that have peculiar shape, funnel like shape, this one is have. Here with the help of this special or peculiar shape, the sound is collected and that is passed through this tube, middle ear. Or the outer ear have a funnel like shape. So this receives the sound, and this passes from this tube, middle ear tube. Here thin membrane in the cavity of the middle ear that is present, and that is called as a eardrum. Here the compressions in sound waves reaches to the this eardrum, and that pressure on the outside increases, and that get pushes inwards. Opposite happens when the rarefaction reaches there, and therefore here see, there is a vibrations occurs in the membrane of the middle ear, in the tympanic membrane or in the ear drum. Then inner ear is here. Here auditory nerves are connected to the brain to that connects to the inner ear to the brain. And here inner ear has a structure which has a shell like structure, and that is called as a cochlea. This receives the vibrations which are coming from the membrane, and that converts into electric signals, and which electric signals passes or that send to the brain with the help of nerves, and brain analyzes the signals and we can hear that type of sound. Here see, these are these outer ear or pinna, then middle ear and inner ear. Now we are going to discuss about the activity sheet number 1. The questions are here. See, first question is, what is the difference between the sound waves and the waves on the surface of the water body? त्याच्यामध्ये लॉन्जिट्यूडनल आणि ट्रान्सवर्स वेव्स याच्याविषयी काय करायचे इथे इन्फॉर्मेशन लिहायची आहे. राईट एनी टू ॲप्लिकेशन्स ऑफ द रिफ्लेक्शन ऑफ द साऊंड विथ विच यू आर वेल फॅमिलियर. ॲप्लिकेशन्स ऑफ रिफ्लेक्शन ऑफ साऊंड जे तुम्हाला माहिती असणारे असे लिहायचे दोन. थर्ड क्वेश्चन सी, माईट हॅव ऑब्झर्व द इनर वॉल्स ऑफ द सिनेमा हॉल्स विच मेजर्स आर applied there to reduce reverberation. Reverberation कमी करण्यासाठी कुठल्या प्रकारचे मेजर्स जे आहेत उपाय हे सिनेमा हॉलमध्ये केलेले असतात हे लिहायचे आहेत. फोर्थ क्वेश्चन सी, राईट एनी थ्री युजेस ऑफ अल्ट्रासाऊंड. अल्ट्रासाऊंडचे तीन युजेस लिहायचे आहेत. देन कलेक्ट इन्फॉर्मेशन अबाउट द अल्ट्रासोनोग्राफी टेक्निक फ्रॉम द इंटरनेट. After this we are going to discuss about the activity sheet number 2, and the reference is the laws of motion. So you know about the displacement and distance. So what is displacement and what is distance? See here. So what is distance? It is the length of the actual path traveled by an object in motion while going from one point to another point. Distance म्हणजे काय पाहिलं. डिस्प्लेसमेंट म्हणजे काय पहा. डिस्प्लेसमेंट इज द मिनिमम डिस्टन्स बिटवीन स्टार्टिंग अँड फिनिशिंग पॉईंट. हे काय आहे, मिनिमम डिस्टन्स आहे स्टार्टिंग आणि फिनिशिंग पॉईंटमधलं. नाव सी, व्हॉट इज द स्पीड अँड व्हेलॉसिटी. स्पीड इज इक्वल टू टोटल डिस्टन्स ट्रॅव्हल अपॉन टाईम रिक्वायर्ड. सो हियर सी, इन एस आय सिस्टीम द युनिट इज मीटर पर सेकंड, इन सी जी एस सिस्टीम इट इज अ सेंटीमीटर पर सेकंड. Then here see, velocity is equal to displacement upon time. Velocity is the displacement that occurs in unit time. Now next see, uniform and non-uniform linear motion. So what is the uniform? So if an object covers equal distances in equal time intervals, it is said to be moving with a uniform speed. If the object covers unequal distances in equal time interval, it is said to be moving with a non-uniform speed. And one example is given here. See, then see here, what is acceleration? What is acceleration? Acceleration is the rate of change of velocity, that is the acceleration. That equals to change in velocity upon time. Here if the initial velocity is u and the time t and final velocity is v, then acceleration is equal to v minus u upon time. Then see, positive, negative and zero acceleration. Acceleration is in the direction of the velocity. When the velocity of an object decreases with time, it has a negative acceleration. When the velocity of an object increases, the acceleration is positive. And if the velocity of the object does not change with time, it has a zero acceleration. So this is of the positive, negative and zero acceleration. So see here, we have three equations of the motion. Here first one is v is equal to u plus at. This is the relation between velocity and time. s is equal to ut plus 1 of 80 square. This is the relation between displacement and time. V square is equal to u square plus 2s. So this is the relation between the displacement and velocity. So all these are three equations. So here see v is the final final velocity, u is the initial velocity, a is the acceleration, and t is the time. Here s is a displacement. Then see here, when an object moves with a constant speed along the circular path, the motion is called as a uniform circular motion. An example is given here, the motion of the stone in the sling. Then here see Newton's first law of motion. An object continues to remain at the rest or in a state of uniform motion along a straight line unless an external unbalanced force acts on it. So that is the Newton's first law of motion. Then see here the momentum. The rate of change of momentum is proportional to the applied force, and the change of momentum occurs in a direction of the force, and that has a formula that equals to change in momentum upon time, that is the rate of change of momentum. Then here see Newton's third law of motion. Every action force has an equal and opposite reaction force which acts simultaneously. This is the Newton's third law of motion. Then see here law of conservation of momentum. Here see when no external force acts on two interacting objects, their total momentum remains constant and it does not change. Or when two objects collide, the total momentum before collision is equal to the total momentum after collision. Now we are going to discuss the questions in activity sheet number 2. Your first question is, how will you decide whether the object is in the motion or in steady state? Second question, see here, find some examples of the circular motions in our day-to-day life. Give 4 examples of these. Third question is, see, observe the motion of the tip of the second arm of the clock. What will you state about the speed and velocity of the tip? Fourth question, which Newton's law of motion is there behind the launching of the rocket? Explain the launching process in your words. Explain law here. Fifth question, see here, explain any 5 motions in our surroundings and explain their motions based on the Newton's law of motion. Asha 5 वेगळ्या काय करायचे मूव्हमेंट्स जे आपल्या सराउंडिंग मध्ये आपल्याला दिसतात, तर त्याच्यामध्ये त्या ज्या मोशन्स आहेत तर त्या न्यूटनच्या लॉनुसार त्याचं एक्सप्लेनेशन द्यायचं आहे. 6 क्वेश्चन, द व्हेलॉसिटीज ऑफ द क्रिकेट बॉल अँड अ टेनिस बॉल आर सेम, बट वाय द टेनिस बॉल कॅन स्टॉप्ड इझिली ॲज कम्पेअर टू द क्रिकेट बॉल, याचं रिझन लिहायचं आहे. सपोज अ स्कूटर अँड अ ट्रक आर कोलायडिंग विथ इच अदर, विच आर ऑफ देम विल बी थ्रोन अप टू लार्जर डिस्टन्स, एक्सप्लेन इन युअर वर्ड्स. तर ट्रक आणि स्कूटर यांच्यामध्ये कोलिजन धडक झाली तर कुठला ह्याच्यामधले जास्त लांबपर्यंत जाऊन पडेल, त्याचं काय करायचं तुम्ही एक्सप्लेनेशन द्यायचं आहे तुमच्या शब्दामध्ये. 8th क्वेश्चन हियर, अन ऑब्जेक्ट मूव्ज 18 मीटर इन फर्स्ट 3 सेकंड्स, देन 22 मीटर इन नेक्स्ट 3 सेकंड अँड 14 मीटर इन द लास्ट 3 सेकंड, व्हॉट इज इट्स ॲव्हरेज स्पीड? याचा तिघांचाही काय करायचं आहे, ॲव्हरेज स्पीड काढायचा आहे. तर ह्याच्यात फक्त काय करायचं आहे, ॲव्हरेज स्पीड काढायचं आहे, म्हणजे डिस्टन्स अपॉन टाईम करून ॲव्हरेज स्पीड काढायचं आहे. सो दिस इज अबाउट द क्वेश्चन्स ऑफ एक्टिविटी शीट नंबर 2. सॉल्व ऑल दीज क्वेश्चंस इन योर नोटबुक.